I'd like to talk to you about the number 98. 98 is a bit large for people to think it's quite a cool number. However, if you take the square root of 98, it equals 9.89949. What I like is that the first two digits are the same as the digits in the number you were taking the square root. And this works for other numbers. If you take the square root of 99, it equals 9.949. It starts with 99. And when I saw this, I saw 98 first. I thought, wait a minute, I wonder if there are other bigger ones. And it turns out there are. If you take the square root of 9,998, that equals 99.98999. And there's your 9998. And all these numbers, and you can keep going, 9,999. If you square root 9,999, it starts 99.99, what was then 49, and there's other stuff going out there, but it starts with those. And this continues. The next one, it's always an even number of nines. So 9,999, and then ending with an 8, and 9,999, ending with a 9. You've got these numbers where if you take their square root, they begin with exactly the same digits, admittedly only in base 10. But I was just doing this in Excel. I made a little spreadsheet and I was putting in all these numbers and I found these and went, I wonder if there are more. And I couldn't find any more where the square root starts with exactly the same digits as the number itself. But then I went, you know what? I wonder if there are any numbers where just after the decimal point, maybe just the digits after there are the same as the number themselves, and there are quite a few. I'll just do a couple. The first one is 77, because if you do the square root of 77, it starts with 8, which is a bit disappointing, but then 77 appears right there. And in fact, any number with, so 9797, and then 997997, and this pattern continues all the way down. Each of those, this one is 98, you ignore that, it then goes 9797, and then I think it's like 95 or something. But this here, so there's 77, there's 9797. This one here starts 998, we ignore that, and then you've got 997997, and then a bunch of stuff after that. But there it is. I find these weird properties of numbers fascinating, and again, I'd never heard of this. No one ever talked to me about numbers where the decimals in the number appear in its square root. I looked online, I couldn't find anyone else talking about these sorts of numbers. I asked some friends, no one had heard of these, and I was like, well, I've got to call them something, because I was making notes on them, I was looking into different types, and so I call them grafting numbers, because you start with a number and then its root just grows off from it. However, up until now, they've been quite boring because there's these two families. There's the 98 family and then the 77 family, which is a quite predictable series of numbers. And I wanted to see if there were more exciting ones. So I thought, how am I going to do this? And up until now, I've been putting this into Excel and doing a spreadsheet. And Excel is great because you can see the numbers as you're doing calculations and you can search for numbers, but you hit the limits quite quickly. And so I thought, you know what? I've been meaning to learn how to program in Python, which is a programming language. If you've done any programming, I highly recommend Python. But don't go through life without being able to program. It's a whole area of a way of thinking and a way of doing things that underpins all our modern technology. At least for a little while, out of interest. It's like everyone should skydive once, because we're the first generation of humans that can jump off that kind of a height. You know, just at will, we go, you know what, this weekend I'm going to fall from a plane and survive, right? No other human's been able to do that. So I programmed a little script and I found all the numbers up to 10 million which appear somewhere in their root before you go past the decimal point. Because once you fall off that decimal point, it is a long way down. It looks like it stopped, but it's just checking bigger and bigger numbers. See, it's found a few more and it's checked the first million at this point. I'll show you the ones I found. So there's another, and I'm not going to bother with the square root sign anymore, just to make life easier. 764, its root is 27.64, and then 054, and so on. And there it is there. 764 appears a little way in. In fact, 765 does the same thing. 27.658, and so on. And there it is there, 765. 5711 gives you 75.5 57115, and there it is there, and that continues. And the next one down was 5736. That gives you 75.7363, so on, and there it is there, 5736. So these, in addition to the ones I showed you before, these are all the other numbers that appear somewhere at the beginning of their square root. Now, mathematicians can be very patronizing towards some of the sciences. In fact, physicists themselves refer to biologists as people doing stamp collecting, because all they're doing is looking at things and just labeling them, right? They're not doing any of the underlying patterns or the reasoning behind it. And I, as much as I make fun of biologists, I also do like stamp collecting. I like biology, for the record. And in maths, there's some great fun doing stamp collecting. So these numbers are meaningless, to be honest. This only works in base 10. There's no rhyme or reason. It could be a complete freak, a complete accident that 5,711, its square root starts 5,711. There could be absolutely no meaning. But I enjoyed writing a computer program as such to search through and to find all these numbers. But then the mathematician in me thought, what if there is a pattern, right? What if there is something underneath these? And so I suddenly looked at these and I went, wait a minute. This one here, 76394, looks a lot like this one here, 7639321. In fact, it's the first five digits of this and then round it up as such. And then, well, wait a minute, what if I take the first three digits of this and round that up? And that's over here, 764. And so it looked like there was this pattern of numbers. And so I wrote a different program to just look for numbers of this form. And I'll show you what I found. If you continue on, this pattern does keep going. The next one down, where are we up to, gets to 3-1. The next one is 7639320 23. That appears in its square root. The one after that was 7639320 2251. The next one is 7639320 I'll make sure I get this right. 02250 03 from memory. Yep, and then the next one is a bit longer, and there's another one a bit longer and a bit longer, and it keeps going. And there is this sequence of numbers that have the grafting property. And I thought, well, what is it? And if you just take this string of numbers, it turns out this string of numbers is 3 minus the square root of 5. If you work out 3 minus the square root of 5 as a number, it equals 0.763932, and then it's exactly the same sequence as far in as you care to go. So this family of grafting numbers are based on this constant, and so I decided this, I call it a grafting constant. And if you take that number and multiply it up, so if you multiply it, well, first of all, by 1,000 and then round it up, you get the first one. If you multiply that by 100 and round it up, you get the next one. If you multiply it by 100, you get the next one, and then so on. You get, there's a whole family. Actually, if you want to write that mathematically, we'll put that in brackets. You're then going to have to multiply this by 10 to the power of 2n minus 1. That will generate your next term up, and in maths, to say round up, we do what's called ceiling brackets. So I draw them like this, there are variations. So it's calculate that, round it up to the next number, and you get a whole family of grafting numbers. So there you are. I was very pleased, because I went from just being the mathematical equivalent of a train spotter pulling out these random numbers to finding some that had an underlying pattern and the constant that generates them. And that made me disproportionately happy. And this may have been number 4, don't get me, I've not come across it, but most things in maths have been number 4. I was at the Maths Jam weekend, which is a Maths Jam conference. So Maths Jams are monthly gatherings in pubs to do maths and talk about fun things. Once a year we get together, so 130 not mathematicians, just people who like maths. We're in a room, and everyone gets 5 minutes to talk about something they assume everyone else will find interesting. And I talked about these numbers. And some people just found the programming aspect of finding these and just categorizing them was interesting, but the mathematicians in the room were a bit more pleased when I could show that there's a family which has an underlying pattern to them. And I don't know what happens. You can look at them, you can do cube roots, you could do this in different bases. Like, there's always another way to generalize this and see what happens.
What do you think about this? What do you think I think about this?
goodness knows. My theory was that as a mathematicians, my theories are not that unusual, right? Because I figure if you find something interesting, someone else will find something interesting. And I found these numbers interesting and went, well, I'm sure I'm unusual in a lot of ways, but there must be some other people who find this stuff fascinating. And so I thought I'd share it with them. And some people did. They thought it was great. And it passed some. I sat on the train and learned computer programming.